Hello everybody, Imminent Storm here, and welcome back to Hearts of Iron 4. In our last episode, we were fighting over here in the United States, aiding our allies, the Free American Empire, in their war against the Democratic United States. We were able to take the cities of Chicago and Detroit, and now we are pushing in a sweeping encirclement maneuver to cut off a few American divisions here and hopefully destroy them. And what also happened is Mexico appears to have had a fascist revolt, a civil war, as well as Argentina. I don't know if we're going to be able to assist Argentina, but we're probably going to be able to assist Mexico as long as the fascists can hold out for a little bit. Because I have an army here that we're going to be sending over. And actually what I want to do with them is I want to delete that front I set up, because the AI is not moving these guys in a way I would want. So we are going to say strategic redeploy and just move to this naval base. And then once they're in that naval base, they can then hop on ships and get across the Pacific. It's going to be a long ride, but hopefully they can get there in time. Because right now, our army is bogged down here on the American front. We can't really do anything. Alright, so let's go ahead and unpause it. Let's get things moving a little slow. One of the other things I wanted to do is we need to start some construction here. On, not construction, but manufacturing of the Hoey medium SP artillery. That needs to get worked on. And the Honi 1 medium tank destroyer. I probably want to actually back off a few we took one too many. Let's see. Let's go with the naval bombers. Okay. Alright, so we now have these tank destroyers and the self-propelled artillery that we now need to put into templates. So we want to go into our templates, and it's going to be in here that we're going to add in medium tank destroyers, medium self-propelled anti-air, and I'm going to add in, because these are going to be some very heavy units. I'm going to go with self-propelled artillery and self-propelled artillery. Alright. So what's the width on this? Supply use. Combat width is 27. It's pretty wide. We may adjust that a little bit. Might maybe get rid of one of these battalions of units once these guys start getting converted to mechanized or motorized infantry. Alright, looks like that they're pushing in there a little bit. Alright, so have these guys got where they need to be? Yes, they are. Alright, so we need them to come over to San Diego. Alright. One other thing I noticed here is just kind of for a little bit of flavor, Omar Bradley is a general in the Free American Empire. So Bradley came over. All right, and now this front, we need to clean this up a little bit. I wanna tighten that front up. You guys, get over here. Fall of Kiev. Kiev, capital of the Ukrainian SSR, has been captured by the advancing German armies in the Soviet Union. Soviet Union's in trouble. I would like to get into that war at some point, but we're a little busy, unfortunately. What I could actually do here is declare war on Mexico, call our allies in. And that means that we can invite Synarchist Mexico into the faction, yes. All right. Actually, it looks like that they're not bad off. They're not that bad off. They should be able to hold their own here. But hopefully once our troops get over there, it will help. Oh, we got some more Marines. Need to be assigned to this guy. Light tank destroyer. Okay, good. Missing equipment production. Medium self-propelled anti-air. I didn't put that on there? Look with the light self-propelled. Oh no, something's already working on that. Let's see. We definitely want all of this. 1940. We need to pick a path for our doctrine here. We're going to go assault and infantry. Let's go with assault. Mechanized defensive. That sounds fun. All right, let's do it. Join wars request. Yes, yes. So let's get that medium self-propelled anti-air. Apparently we didn't queue that up. All right, then let's get that working on there. All right, light self-propelled artillery. Let's improve our artillery. Ooh, it looks like the American Empire is starting to aid the Mexicans. And it looks like we were able to cut off a few guys. Let's get some guys in there. Get these guys reduced. Alright. And attack, 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 attack. Now just get in there. Has our army arrived yet? No. Not quite even halfway there yet. Oh, what's this? Naval combat. They're just some convoys. Okay. Couple of our submarines found the convoys, and I guess they sunk them. All right. Everybody just get in there. Yeah. Good. Very successful. Alright, let's make sure that everybody here is assigned that front line. You guys. Delete all orders. And I want to assign you a new front. We're gonna bring you up here. And we're going to say make a push to Washington, D.C. And in the meantime, you guys launch an offensive like this. To push that out. Oh, we can modify the government. Let's actually modify some of these. Now we're fine on that. Do we want to go free trade? Factory output? Resources to market plus 80%? Or do we want to switch to a war economy? I think we want to switch to a war economy. Let's do that. Okay. Denmark joined the Allies. German Reich declare war on Denmark. Yeah, looks like the fascist Mexicans are holding their own here. But the Americans are running into a little bit of trouble. German Reich declare war on Norway. Our guys are arriving. Alright, what is your planning bonus? Airbase expansion. Okay. Fire off your orders. Let's see. Do you want to go with super heavy battleships, naval air innovation? Let's do that. We're short 6 steel. Can we get a little bit more steel? Looks like we're getting some shipyards built. Alright, our forces have arrived. First thing you want to do is just drive into there. I'm not even going to bother with a battle plan or anything. One other thing I want to do is get more military factories being built. Because we need more military factories. Just lots more. Ooh, assassination of Leon Trotsky. Okay. Just build them. Lots of them. We also need naval yards, however. I'm going to build those at home. I just need to expand our production capacity. Oh, and there's one thing I think I forgot to do. The heavy Mogami class, we are switching that up. Actually, what we're going to do is we're going to reduce this to 1. So that will finish. And then we are going to queue up the Tone class. Oh, no. We want to add Tone class. And move them up. I think we finished one of the Amatos. Where would it have deployed? I should see it on the map, shouldn't I? These guys are also the auto deploy. Japan Fleet 1. Hold on just a moment. No, we want you guys to all deploy here so that I know where you're supposed to be. Alright, there we go. Okay. We're gonna knock this division down. Alright, let's see. How are you guys? You guys are ready to go. Hit it. Ah, just get in there. No, I guess you'll stay there. There's nobody there. Just everybody move in. So you attack them there. You attack them there. Okay, good. Just want to straighten that line out a little bit. Just one of you swinging over there. Okay, yeah. We've almost won this. You see, I don't know if that really matters at all. There's no victory points or anything like that down there. So what I might want to do is just take one unit, give it a front line. Cancel his attack. Take the rest of his army. How do I know who's assigned to a front line? I think it's that guy. Yeah, so we'll just give all these guys the front line here. Tell them to attack like that, and then just execute it as soon as they arrive. and we'll just contain this guy. Alright, so all you guys, hit New Orleans. Is there like two separate? Yeah, there's two separate ones there. Alright. Forget it. You stop attacking. What I'll do is I'm going to take two divisions, send them up there on the other side of the Mississippi. This is going pretty well. Oh, I need to tighten this up a little bit, though. Tighten that up. We just want you to stay on the spearhead. Just stay on the spearhead. Yeah, there we go. And we're going to adjust your orders a little bit. Baltimore, Washington. Area, just like that. Oh. No, that's alright. And fire it. Man, how did he get 25 of 24 divisions? Hold on. Oh, this guy. You. You're not supposed to be there. You're supposed to be on that. There we go. Actually, I probably want to tighten this up a lot more. Concentrate the forces there. What do we got here? We need new research. Is it 41 yet? No, but we got a 50% increase. Let's go with that. Let's get those mechanized infantry. Alright, we need to make another adjustment here. Limited exports. Factory output, construction speed. Export focus. Factory output. Let's go with free trade. Let's do that. Insufficient oil. I know how to fix that. Give me another synthetic oil plant. And make it a priority. It'll be done in 2 months. Plus or minus. We are attacking Washington, D.C. Attack Washington, D.C. You guys, attack Baltimore. How are my stockpiles looking? Not so good. Actually, we got good stockpile infantry equipment, but we're way short on a lot of stuff. Expeditionary force request. Wants to send 9 divisions. No! No. You need to keep those. Stop attacking. Alright, so you guys, minus you, need to go set up a front line over here. Stop your orders. Delete all orders. You keep your front line there. You guys all just stop where you're at. Alright, the rest of you... do a front line down there. There we go. Alright, we improved our artillery. We need to improve our anti-air. Yeah, we have available planes in reserve, but I'm not worried about that right now. And what you are going to do is you're going to set up an attack to here. Naval Air Innovations. Research bonus for destroyer models. We'll take that. Tungsten steel. How are we short 94 steel? How are we short 94 steel? Okay. Let's see. Naval doctrines. We need to get the Shokaku class. And let's see. Agano class. Let's research some ships. What happened to all of our steel? Oil. Okay. All right, we'll set our steel imports to zero. And that means we have ...136 steel. Okay, what is that gonna do? Ooh, that really puts a crimp on our... civilian factories and construction. I think that's probably because a lot of our ships all of a sudden started being built. The Amato class is going to free up a whole bunch of steel, which when we're on a surplus of that, we will have to see about reducing those traded goods. Alright, you... execute. Nope, that's actually not gonna work. Stop it. Cancel all the attacks. Doesn't look like these guys are gonna be enough, so we'll just have to hold off here until we can bring more forces down. Can you guys get in there, please? Fall of Rome? What? What? Oh, the UK did an amphibious invasion of Italy. Well. That's trouble. Oh my goodness, they're almost to Moscow. They are almost to Moscow. We'll have to see what happens if the Soviet Union falls. That could get interesting. Alright, so it looks like that we can't advance, and neither can they. All right, let's see. We've taken Washington, D.C. and Baltimore. All right. So, what we're going to want to do is how far along are we to the surrender of the United States? Japanese-American War. They are at 84% towards capitulation. All right, so you guys stop, delete all orders, set up a new line here. And I want to have you guys push to New York. Oh, that's a little goofy looking. Let's actually say let's push to here. And let's say we'll have you guys move like, we want you to get through Philadelphia, so yeah, slide like that. Up the coast. Free dockyards. Okay, so what do we don't have any carriers being built. We're researching this Shokaku. ...109 days. So we'll probably wait to start building carriers until we get that. Tone, Mogami, Asashio. What am I doing? Or we could just put more stuff on Tone class. Yeah, there we go. Alright, so what do we want to do here? Let's get an aircraft designer. We'll go with light aircraft. We'll go with Mitsubishi. Or Mitsubishi. It's probably better pronunciation there. Alright, what are your... bonuses? We'll let those build up a little bit more before we execute the plan. Alright. Now you guys... you guys, let's get rid of that and make sure that all of these guys are on you guys hit New Orleans Agano class. Okay, so we need Akizuki class. Yeah, let's research that. So we can switch up our light to Agano's. So let's back this off to 1. I don't want to do infinite Tone class. Let's just do 5 of those. Let's do Agano. No. Agano. And we'll queue them up. Let this one finish. And then we'll start building that one. And then we want them distributed here. Perfect. Oh, look at this. China is sending divisions over. I don't know if they're going to go into Mexico or if they're going to go into the U.S. Ooh, this is a problem. This is a problem. Alright, what we're going to need to do is... You need to do this. Delete. Delete. You. Set your front line across that entire line. And then we're going to give you the order to push. Probably all this way. Instead. Yeah, that's what we're going to do. Alright. Recontain the Americans. Do not let them swoop around behind us and cut us off. Convoy raider. We sunk. Who is that? That can't be... That's not... No idea who that is. Let's see. Let's get improved signal companies. Let's get improve recon and improve signal companies. Push into Pittsburgh. Have you pushed there? Convoy protection, all right. We'll go with the infrastructure effort. Even though that's in China. Stop your attack there. You attack them there. You support. Have you attack them here? Have you support? Have you attack? So, this army set up an offensive line along the coast. And then just hit it. Anti-air upgrade. Alright, so we want to go with Type 1 47mm anti-tank guns. Let's do that. Let's finally get this little pocket taken care of. Wait a minute, how did Mexico get all of Texas? That's odd. Is that why I lost all that steel? Where were those Chinese units? They're still just kind of milling around in the Pacific. All right. You guys ready? You guys are ready. Hit it. You guys, like, just move in. This is almost over. Alright. Oh, the Chinese are garrisoning the American border with Canada. Interesting. Interesting. Okay. Can you, like, drive around there for a second? Actually, drive around through the Delmarva Peninsula? So, yes. Okay. Oh, an American fleet got pushed out of port. We're somehow short 19 steel. Because the Netherlands is not delivering on their... Let's go to Brazil. Wait a minute, why am I getting steel from France? No, we don't want steel from France. I want steel from the Free American Empire. That's who we want steel from. Oh, oh! Free American Empire declared war on Chile. The war's over. Okay, so these guys, get yourself back. Get yourself back home. All right, so get to a port is a better idea. You guys all get to a port. And you, the dawn of the North America Alliance. Lazaro Cardenas announced today that Mexico has reached out to form a new alliance. North American Alliance have made a public their intent to cooperate in case of war. Let's see. Mexico is part of the North American Alliance with Mexico. Alright, let's see. You guys... Well, no, let's actually bring the infantry down here. These guys... Let's strategically redeploy them back to a Pacific port. So let's bring them back to Los Angeles. Call to arms request from Free American Empire wants me to go to war with the Philippines and Mexico. The Philippines? Accept. Okay. The Philippines. That's interesting. So we're going to have to redeploy the fleet. We need to get our Marines back because we're going to need to launch an attack on the Philippines, apparently. All right. Well, we are pretty long in this episode, so we are going to have to do that at another time. And that's who that was. All these convoys we sunk were Philippine convoys. Oh, because Philippines... were a puppet of the United States. That's right. So yeah, they definitely would have joined the war against us when we went to war with the United States. I didn't even think about that. Alright, well, we will take care of that when we come back next episode. So thanks for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Go ahead, like, subscribe, and comment. And I will see you next time.